Welcome to the part 8 of my video lectures. In part 7 of my video lecture, I discuss about the derivation of flux linkage and inductance of a three-phase lines with asymmetrical spacing. Now we will discuss about the three-phase lines with bundled phase conductors. The objective of this lecture is to learn the technique of mathematical operation and evaluation in deriving the inductance of the three-phase lines with bundled phase conductors. In theory and in actual practice, the high voltage gradient on the surface of the conductor in EHV line or extra high voltage line is reduced considerably by having two or more conductors per phase in close proximity. This means that with a bundled conductor per phase, there is a lower voltage gradient at the conductor surface and have less tendency to ionize the air around the conductor. Ionization produces the undesirable effect called corona. Now, as we have said earlier, that in order to reduce the inductance of a transmission line, we can do this by increasing the radius of the conductor, in which the effective radius of the conductor should be increased. And this can be done by means of bundled conductors. In fact, bundled conductors are used for two purposes. Number one, it reduces the electric field strength on conductor surface, and in turn, it reduces corona losses, radio interference, and the electric stress. Looking in this figure, we will see that electric field lines is different with magnetic field lines. The electric field lines are perpendicular to the surface of the conductor, while the magnetic field lines are parallel to the circular surface of the conductor. Then why it reduces the electric field strength? Suppose we have two conductors with different size. The first conductor has large diameter than the other. You will notice that in large diameter wire, the distance between electric field lines is much larger than this small diameter wire, which means that the electric field density is much lower with large diameter wire. So with lower density, the voltage gradient is also low, and in turn, the corona effect is also low. Number two, it increases effective radius GMR of the conductor or the self distance of the conductor, and in turn, it reduces the inductance. And this is one of the reasons why we use bundled conductors. Now let us look with different configuration of bundled conductors. We have 2, 3, and 4 bundled conductors wherein the bundle are separated by spacer dampers to prevent clashing of the conductors. For example, in the 2 bundled conductors with distance D between conductors, the experts said that the normal distance D is approximately 10 times the diameter of the conductor. In computing the inductance of bundled conductors, we need to determine first the effective radius or the geometric mean radius GMR of bundled conductors. To find the effective radius or GMR, this is the formula for two bundled conductors, where R is the radius and D is the distance between conductors. That formula came from this equation. The number of terms came from squaring the number of conductors. So for two conductors, it is 2 squared, which is 4. Whatever is the number of terms, it is also the root. So for two conductors, the first 2 term is the radius of 2 conductors, and the last 2 term are the distances between conductors. So we have the radius R1 and R2 and the distance of D12 and D21. Now for 3 conductors, it is 3 square, which is 9. The number of terms is 9 and also the root. So we have 3 radius and 6 distances, and therefore it arrives to this formula. Now for 4 conductors is 4 square, which is 16. So the number of terms is 16 and also the root. So we have 4 radius and 12 distances, including the diagonal distance. And therefore, it arrives to this formula. We already derived in part 7 video the inductance of three-phase lines with unequal spacing. And this is the formula of three-phase lines with unequal spacing. And this is the formula for three-phase lines line with equal spacing. Now, for bundled conductors with unequal spacing, this is the formula. For bundled conductors with equal spacing, this is the formula. We will notice that when three conductors of a three-phase circuit has unequal spacing, you need to get the effective distance of the geometric mean distance, or GMD. If the phase of the three-phase line is composed of bundled conductors, for example, 2, 3, or 4 bundle, you need to get the effective radius or the geometric mean radius or GMR. In conclusion, whether it is single phase or three phase, and the distance between conductors is equal, and the phase conductor is not bundled, if you want to calculate the inductance of phase conductors, you will use this formula. But if the distance is not equal, you will use the formula of this inductance A. If the distance is equal, but the phase is composed of bundled conductors, you will use this formula. That is the end of my lecture. Thank you, and please watch the part 9, which is the sample problem.